I think she enjoyed it, and I sat on her from the fence bareback, and it was all good. So then I came back. This is more energetic than
right.
She usually is,
yeah,
which I'm happy about.
Just a little more even though it's there for when you need to come right back up and use it.
It's more of a release.
Yeah, okay. A release for her. But ideally, hopefully, is what she'll catch is if that whip has to come back up. Yeah, like that's the first sign of you better keep it moving.
I know, and it's right now it's kind of restless. Actually, I got the mane and tail detangled last week, but I didn't get the pull off them. They're doing some other stuff.
There you go. Yep.
Live in some of those cottonwood trees up there.
Ah.
And some of them are Swenson's hawks, and I'm not sure if some of them are redtails. Mm. Now that's better. It's not the most extended walk, but
yes.
Turn and walk from the other way before you do trot, or just go ahead. You usually go ahead and go into the trot.
I usually will go ahead and go in, as long as they've had a sufficient amount of walking to physically kind of stretch everything out.
Now, do you ask for more of a walk than this?
No.
Okay. This is better than.
Yeah, good. Than what it was the last time I was here too. Yeah.
Joe's? Trot?
Going forward, starting off, you know. She's like, I heard it.
How long do I want her to hold the position nicely?
You know, if she'll do it.
Huh?
She was respectful in that sense that she, you know, she didn't get cranky about moving out. She kept her head in front of her. So yeah, so the intermittent points, like you thought, is this last take off her trot was much more responsive. She just kind of stepped right up into it. And she kept pretty much the same pace throughout. Even when she came off the rail, she couldn't, you know, stayed up.
She didn't usually, but she's come off the rail and work to get her out, and as soon as she's out, she's
like,
plop. I lose it before I can keep the momentum.
So that's always something to shoot for a goal, too. Say if she gets there, it's just learning, hey, just scoot out, stay here. If she goes to quit on you, push her just a hair longer, and then ask her to do her walk.
Okay.
That way she connects, you know, just because you got back to the rail doesn't mean you get to quit.
Right. Exactly.
You know, like I said, I figured that, yes, when you say, yeah, perfect. And really good timing there just to be like, yeah, no, and she's, all right, I'm moving, and you just let all that energy and, you know, everything soften back up.
Trot.
She was going to, and that was just, I wanted
it
to see, but that was her normal anticipation. We quit here last time. What about if we quit here again?
It may help after the farrier is out with those stumbles.
Yeah.
Those are,
oh, yeah.
She's got long feet, and I sent pictures to him, and he was like,
oh,
wow, she's really growing. I said, yeah, because he's not due back until the middle of June, and I said he didn't know how fast she'd grow.
She's gonna grow, right?
And so she's got pads and clogs and
right. Emulators
in, and he
right.
was like, okay. But hopefully that will help the front. The backs are on a different cycle.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Walk.